Hello guys, today we'll be discussing about the second stage of tooth development, which is the cap stage. The first stage that we have discussed earlier was the bell stage. Let us quickly revise that. So, in the first stage, what happens is, from the oral ectoderm, what is coming out is the dental lamina. The dental lamina proliferates and forms a bud. Okay, so in this bud, it is known as enamel organ. Here, the peripheral cells are the cuboidal cells and the central cells are the polygonal cells. Okay, then surrounding this, there is ectomesenchymal condensation, which is known as dental papilla. Then the ectomesenchymal condensation surrounding the dental papilla and the enamel organ is known as dental sac. Okay, now what happens is, this is the tooth bud and this is the enamel organ. ठीक है, यहाँ पे ectomesenchymal condensation है और माइटोटिक एक्टिविटी, ectomesenchymal condensation प्लस माइटोटिक एक्टिविटी. अब क्या होता है, इस टूथ बर्ड के डिफरेंट एरियाज में डिफरेंट रेट ऑफ ग्रोथ इज सीन. ओके, सो बिकॉज ऑफ डिफरेंशियल ग्रोथ और अनइक्वल ग्रोथ, ठीक है, डिफरेंशियल या फिर अनइक्वल ग्रोथ की वजह से क्या होता है, एक शैलो इमेजिनेशन हो जाता है यहाँ पे ऑफ द एक्टोमेसेनकाइम. दिस इट इन्वेड्स हियर. ओके, सो बिकॉज ऑफ दिस अनइक्वल ग्रोथ देयर इज द शैलो इमेजिनेशन ऑफ द एक्टोमेसेनकाइम, बिकॉज ऑफ विच व्हाट हैपेंस इज, जो हमारे आउटर पेरिफेरल क्यूबॉइडल सेल्स हैं वो अब प्रोलीफरेट होके दो पार्ट्स में डिवाइड हो जाते हैं. ठीक है, सो यहाँ पे थ्री लेयर्स ऑफ सेल्स आर सीन इन द इनैमल ऑर्गन. तो व्हाट आर द थ्री लेयर्स ऑफ सेल्स, it is first of all is the outer enamel epithelium, it is the peripheral cells, okay, and they are cuboidal in shape. Remember, outer enamel epithelium is present in the convexity of the cap. Then next is the inner dental or enamel, see it is also known as dental epithelium. So next is the inner enamel epithelium. Here the cells become tall, they are columnar in shape, okay, and they are seen in the concavity of the cap. Okay, they are seen in the concavity of the cap. Now what happens is, the central polygonal cells, here occurs the formation of the stellate reticulum. Let us see how stellate reticulum is formed. Before understanding how stellate reticulum is formed, I would like to tell you that the nutrition for the growth of these cells in the bud stage also, that was derived from the ectomesenchyme, which was dental papilla and dental sac. ठीक है, तो इनका nutrition dental papilla और dental sac से आता था. अब यहाँ पर क्या हो रहा है, stellate reticulum form हो रहा है. So let us see how stellate reticulum is forming. See, this is the invagination of the dental papilla. Now this invagination looks like the complete tooth germ, it is placed over someone's head. Okay, तो ये किसी के सिर पर रखी हुई कैप की तरह लगता है, therefore it is known as cap stage. Now see what happens is, the central polygonal cells, they grow in size, okay? Earlier they were of smaller size, they have now grown in the size, they proliferate and they also increase in number, okay? Because of this, what happens is, since many cells are formed, they have grown in size, they have proliferated and increased in number, they move away from their source of nutrition, which is the dental papilla or the mesenchymal condensation. ठीक है, तो क्या होता है, जो central polygonal cells हैं वो proliferate करते हैं और वो move away, increase होते हैं number में, size में, और वो move away from the source of nutrition, which is dental papilla. Okay, तो ये लोग they move away from their source of nutrition, that is dental papilla. और यहाँ पे इनर इनेमल एपिथीलियम की सेल्स आ जाती है. ओके, सो व्हाट हैपेंस इज, दे स्टार्ट सिक्रीटिंग, सिंस दे हैव मूव्ड अवे, दे स्टार्ट सिक्रीटिंग व्हाट, ग्लाइकोसामाइनोग्लाइकन्स. दे सिक्रीट जीएजी व्हिच इज ग्लाइकोसामाइनोग्लाइकन्स. ओके, इन द इंटरसेल्युलर स्पेसेस. सी, let us draw only the cells. These were the cells, polygonal. Now they have increased in number and also in size. They have proliferated. Because of this, what is happening is, they have moved away from source of nutrition. Now what they are doing is, they have started secreting glycosaminoglycans in the intercellular spaces. Okay, now since this GAG, they are hydrophilic. Hydrophilic means water loving. So what happens is, water is attracted into the intercellular spaces. अब देखो, जैसे ये एक सेल है, ये एक है, ये एक है, ठीक है, यहाँ पे they have secreted what, GAG, GAG है यहाँ पे, this has attracted water and it swells because it absorbs water, it is hydrophilic, so it swells, it absorbs water and it swells because, and it is present in the ground substance, that is the intercellular space now. So it swells and then what happens, the intercellular compartments, jo intercellular compartments hain wo widen ho jate hain and ye jo cells hain they shrink. Intercellular compartments jo hain ye wide ho jate hain aur jo cells hain they shrink and they are forced apart. See what happens. This is how the cells, they are joined only by the desmosomal connections. और यहाँ पर पूरा water है, GAG, glycosaminoglycans, they have attracted water. The cells, they are pulled apart, retaining their desmosomal connections. बस इनके क्या क्या बचे हैं, desmosomal connections are left of the cells and they have been pulled apart. So they result in, अब क्या हो रहा है, polygonal cells का shape कैसा हो जा रहा है, star shaped. So stellate reticulum are star shaped cells. And these star-shaped cells at the center of the enamel organ, they are known as, they are present in the center of the enamel organ and they are known as stellate reticulum. Okay, so this is how the process of, this is what is the process of formation of stellate reticulum, that when the central polygonal cells, they proliferate, they move away from their source of nutrition, which is the dental papilla. And then what happens is they start secreting glycosaminoglycans, GAG, in the intercellular substance. This intercellular substance, just GAG in the intercellular substance, is hydrophilic. It absorbs water and it swells. The ground substance kya hota hai? Swell ho jata hai. So the cells are pulled apart and they are just joined by the desmosomal connections. So now the polygonal cells, they become what? Star shaped. Okay. Now, what is the function of stellate reticulum? See, it has two functions. One is mechanical protection. And other is nutrition. So, because of the stellate reticulum with its rich content of water and glycosaminoglycan, it acts as shock absorber. Okay? And it gives cushion-like consistency. अब ये दोनों क्यों हो रहा है? Why is it acting like shock absorber and giving cushion-like consistency? Because of its glycosaminoglycan and water content. ठीक है? So the inner and इनर इनामल एपिथीलियम सेल्स को अगर कोई भी टाइप के मैकेनिकल इंसल्ट हो रहा है, सो दैट वुड दे वुड स्टेलेट रेटिकुलम सेल्स वुड प्रिवेंट देम, वुड प्रोटेक्ट देम एंड दे वुड गिव देम अ कुशन लाइक कंसिस्टेंसी. ठीक है, तो ये शॉक को एब्जॉर्व कर लेगा, शॉक यहाँ पे डिस्ट्रीब्यूट हो जाएगा. सेकेंड इज वॉट? सेकेंड इज द सेकेंड फंक्शन ऑफ स्टेलेट रेटिकुलम इज न्यूट्रिशन. सो because of high amount of glycosaminoglycans, they may act as a source of nutrition, specially jab change ho jata hai. Inner enamel epithelium ki wajah se jab source of nutrition is changed, then these high amount of glycosaminoglycans, they can act as a source of nutrition for various cells. So this is about the structure of enamel organ. ठीक है, तो कैप स्टेज में इनामल ऑर्गन की तीन सेल्स हैं, आउटर इनामल एपिथीलियम, इनर इनामल एपिथीलियम एंड सेंटर में स्टेलेट रेटिकुलम. वेयर इज बर्थ स्टेज में बर्थ स्टेज में इनामल ऑर्गन वाज हैविंग ओनली टू सेल्स. नाउ नेक्स्ट इज डेंटल पैपिला. सो देर आर ऑल्सो चेंजेस सीन इन द डेंटल पैपिला. वॉट हैपन्स इज बिकॉज ऑफ द ऑर्गेनाइजिंग influence of epithelium. See, ये जो inner enamel epithelium, outer enamel epithelium और stellate reticulum है, यहाँ की cells जो हैं ये ऑर्गेनाइज हो रही है, मतलब अलग अलग डिवाइड हो गया, आउटर अलग हो गया, इनर अलग हो गया, सेंटर में stellate reticulum आ गया. तो इसका जो ऑर्गेनाइजिंग इन्फ्लुएंस है, इसकी वजह से क्या होता है? प्रोलीफरेशन होता है ऑफ द एक्टोमेसेनकाइमल सेल्स का, या फिर ये कहाँ की सेल्स होती है? न्यूरल क्रेस्ट सेल्स. सो देयर इज प्रोलीफरेशन ऑफ द एक्टोमेसेनकाइमल और द न्यूरल क्रेस्ट सेल्स एंड दे कंडेंस हो जाते हैं बिकॉज ऑफ हाई माइटोटिक एक्टिविटी और डेंटल पैपिला बनाते हैं. तो डेंटल पैपिला में क्या होता है? अब देयर इज एक्टिव budding of capillaries and mitotic figures. See, there is active budding of capillaries now seen in the dental papilla and there are numerous mitotic figures which are seen. Okay, now this dental papilla is the main source of nutrition for the inner enamel epithelial cells now. ठीक है, सो डेंटल पैपिला क्या होता है? बिकॉज ऑफ द ऑर्गेनाइजिंग इन्फ्लुएंस ऑफ द एपिथीलियम, इट ऑर्गेनाइजेस, कंडेंसेस एंड देर इज इंक्रीज्ड अमाउंट ऑफ माइटोटिक एक्टिविटी, देर इज एक्टिव बडिंग ऑफ कैपिलरीज सीन एंड इट इज़ द मेन सोर्स ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन फॉर द इनर इनामल एपिथीलियम. यहाँ पे बहुत ज़्यादा इंक्रीज्ड अमाउंट ऑफ माइटोटिक एक्टिविटी भी होगा और एक्टिव बडिंग ऑफ कैपिलरीज भी दिखेगा. ठीक है, Then next is the dental sac or the dental follicle. So along with the development of enamel organ and the dental papilla, there is marginal condensation of the ectomesenchyme. इसमें क्या हो रहा है? Marginal condensation. Okay, so there is marginal condensation of the ectomesenchyme surrounding the enamel organ and the dental papilla. ठीक है, gradually marginal condensation के साथ साथ क्या होगा यहाँ पे? Dense fibrous bands will be seen. ठीक है, so these dense fibrous bands, what are they? They are the primitive dental sac. Okay, so these are the changes which are seen in the cap stage. Let us revise them quickly. First of all, the enamel organ. Here there are three cells seen in the enamel organ. One is the outer enamel epithelium, it is cuboidal. Then is the inner enamel epithelium, they are columnar. Stellate reticulum, they are star shaped cells. How they are formed, I have told you, and they have two functions. One is mechanical and the other is nutrition. In mechanical, they act as shock absorber and they give cushion like consistency to the inner enamel epithelial cells. Okay, now dental papilla. In dental papilla, what is taking place is there is active budding of capillaries. Active capillary budding and increased mitotic figures. Then is the dental sac or the dental follicle. Here what is happening is there is marginal condensation taking place and dense fibrous bands are formed which surround the dental papilla and the enamel organ. These dense fibrous bands are what? They are the primitive dental sac. So this is it about the cap stage. Thank you. Keep visiting.